This is an update in my continuing coverage of the Trappist-1 system, a fascinating solar system that could host up to 7 roughly Earth-sized planets where the conditions could be right for liquid water and thus hold the potential for life. See my other videos on this channel for more backstory. When I was a kid sitting in grade school science classes in the 1980s, I remember 2 scientific consensuses that stick in my mind to this day. One was that even though we had never seen one, or indeed any evidence of one, exoplanets outside our solar system almost certainly existed. There was no reason they shouldn't. All you need to form them is a sufficient amount of solid material around a star to coalesce into planets. And that clearly happened here, so unless rocks and dust were rare in the universe, it was a good bet that it happened elsewhere. That consensus turned out to be correct. In 1992, the existence of an exoplanet was confirmed, and since those days, we have discovered evidence of well over 3,000 planets not located in our solar system, scattered among a wide variety of stars in our galaxy. The other consensus that I remember was that, at the time, there wasn't any particular reason to think that Earth was rare. Indeed, blue jewel worlds like our own could populate the universe to such an extent that there could be untold thousands of civilizations in our galaxy alone, allowing for science fiction universes like Star Trek, where the discovery and contact of such civilizations was a routine and often unpleasant and tricky occurrence. After all, if exoplanets turned out to be common, then why not? What would be so special about Earth? On its face, it would seem like only serendipity favored it. After all, it just happens to be a certain size located at a certain distance from its star. And out of the vast multitude of stars in our galaxy alone, surely there would be many analogs of Earth that took advantage of that same kind of luck. But that consensus has changed. We now know that many things have come together to make our planet the way it is. Atmospheric composition, orbital stability, the presence of a moon to help keep Earth rotating on its axis, the stability of the sun are just a few of the many factors that make this planet an abode where complex life could evolve. Earth is probably not common at all. In fact, it now seems likely that it is an extremely rare kind of world that we won't encounter much as we explore our universe. And that leads us to Trappist-1. This is a star system full of could-bes. We see evidence of at least 7 worlds that appear to be of a similar size to Earth. More, they cluster in close to their dim, small red dwarf sun in such a way that at least a portion of them might, depending on the specific conditions present on those worlds, be able to support liquid water. Where there is liquid water, there's the possibility of life as we know it. Again, after all, we know that happened here. A new climate model, which is no doubt one of many to come, may give us a picture of what these worlds might be like, and suggest which planet astronomers should take a look at first. Also, models like this, and models of what the spectra of the planets might be like, are important because as scientists collect the data on these worlds in future years, they can then compare them to the models and see which ones fit best. According to the new model by Eric Wolf of the University of Colorado, linked to his paper in the description below, the best chances for liquid water in this system would be on Trappist-1e. Wolf looked at the 3 most likely planets for liquid water, Trappist-1d, E, and F. In the model, the other 4 planets of the system didn't even come close. The farther out planets in the system would be frozen solid, and the inner planets would be too hot. Wolf modeled a variety of possible atmospheres for these 3 candidate worlds. To do this, he assumed that water, in whatever form, was freely available in the system. This is a reasonable assumption. The planets are modeled to have formed farther out from the star, where ices are likely to have been present, and then the planets migrated closer after formation. From there, he modified a model originally intended to study Earth's climate to produce the most complex model of the Trappist-1 system we so far have. Now, modeling planetary climates is a tricky business, Earth especially. As a result, more models are needed for a consensus to be arrived at as to what's going on with these planets. But in Wolf's model, out of the 3 most likely candidates, only Trappist-1e made the grade for liquid water. Planet D is too close to the star. If it had liquid water, it would simply boil off into a thick water vapor atmosphere. That should cause a runaway greenhouse effect, producing a planet perhaps similar to Venus. Planet F has the opposite problem. It's too far from the star, and any water on its surface would be frozen solid. Wolf found no combination of atmospheric gases which could keep it warm enough. Even carbon dioxide would freeze out, according to the model. Not so with Planet E. Liquid water was predicted to be possible there. But would that planet be Earth-like? Not likely. The planets at TRAPPIST-1 are probably tidally locked, given their proximity to their star. This means that TRAPPIST-1e would always present the same face towards its star, much like the Moon is similarly tidally locked with Earth and always shows us the same face. This would create an eyeball-like world, where you would have liquid water at the point on the planet that received the most light from the star. The rest would be ice. How much of the planet is conducive to liquid water is unknown. It would depend on if the sunlight was striking an ocean or a drier continental landscape, the content of the atmosphere, and so on, but perhaps around 20% of the surface could be Earth-like in temperature. But as we're seeing with our own solar system, Earth-like worlds are not the exclusive domain of liquid water. There are a variety of conditions, such as those of Enceladus or Europa, that could allow for subsurface liquid water. While it will be a long time before we know if such things are possible in the TRAPPIST-1 system, we at least know that the possibility for one potentially habitable planet more in the grain of Earth is on the table. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently with an upcoming book. It's called Supermind and asks if our universe is really a computer simulation. And be sure to check out my other books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.